Hi, this is Leah from OpenIntro. In this video, we will learn how to carry out a confidence interval for the difference of two proportions. According to a report on sleep deprivation by the Centers of Disease Control and Prevention, the proportion of California residents who reported insufficient rest or sleep during each of the preceding 30 days is 8%, while this proportion is 8.8% for Oregon residents. These data are based on simple random samples of 11,545 California and 4,691 Oregon residents. Calculate a 95% confidence interval for the difference between the proportions of Californians and Oregonians who are sleep deprived and interpret in the context of the data. So in order to structure our response, we're going to use what I've abbreviated the I4C framework. The ICCCC stands for identify, choose, check, calculate, and conclude. So first we want to identify what it is we're trying to estimate. So we want to identify the parameter and the confidence level with which we'll estimate it. Here, the parameter of interest is a difference. It's the difference between the proportion of Californians that are sleep deprived, P1, and the proportion of Oregonians that are sleep deprived, P2. We want to estimate this at the 95% confidence level. So next, we'll choose the appropriate confidence interval procedure because we have two proportions and we're looking at their difference. We can choose a two proportion Z interval for difference of proportions. Next, we want to check that the conditions for this confidence interval procedure are satisfied. We need either two independent random samples or two randomly assigned treatments, and we need the success failure condition for both groups. So we need all four of those terms to be greater than or equal to 10. For the first condition, we do have two independent random samples. These are taken from distinct states, so they're independent of each other. And clearly the sample sizes are small enough that they're less than 10% of the overall population sizes. If we plug in our sample sizes and our sample proportions, we can see that all of these are greater than or equal to 10. Now we're ready to calculate our interval. We're using the form point estimate plus or minus critical value times standard error of estimate. We're trying to estimate P1 minus P2 here, so our point estimate will be the difference in sample proportions, P hat 1 minus P hat 2. Our critical value, since we're basing this on a normal distribution, is a Z star. And we'll be looking at the standard error of P hat 1 minus P hat 2. Now, our sample proportions, we can plug in. For Z star, for 95% confidence, we'll use 1.96. If we don't remember how to find the standard error of a difference of proportions, we can look it up. So here, we see that the standard error of P hat 1 minus P hat 2 is given by this square root. And so we can plug the terms in as shown here, the sample proportions and the sample sizes. And now we have our confidence interval. So our point estimate for the difference is minus 0.008. And then we have plus or minus the margin of error term there. So we can evaluate this. I'm going to use a shortcut on the calculator on the TI. I'm going to go to stat, over to tests. And since this is two proportions, we're gonna do two prop Z int. So we have to find two prop Z int. So here it is, two prop Z int. X1 is the number of yeses. So how did we get this number? This is 8% of the 11,545. And you can even type it right in here. 0.08 times 11,545. And of course, there's some rounding in this percent because X1 is number of people, so that has to be an integer. So let's make sure this is an integer. So let's round this to 924. If you don't put X1 and X2 as integers, you'll just get a calculator error. Now, N1, the sample size for group 1, which is California, is the 11,545. And how did we get this number? This was the 0.088. That's 8.8% of the 4,691. And so we have to round that to 413. And there's the sample size for the second group. We're using a confidence level of 0.95. And now we can calculate, and we get the lower and upper bound of our confidence interval. Okay, so we can record the lower and upper bound. And now we're ready to interpret our interval. We're 95% confident that the true parameter of interest is between our lower and upper bound. The parameter we've identified at the outset, and that's the difference between the proportion of Californians and the proportion of Oregonians that are sleep deprived. So we're 95% confident that that true difference is between -1.75% and 0.15%. And now, how should we interpret this? Do we have evidence that one group has a higher proportion of sleep-deprived residents? Well, if the entire interval were positive, since we are doing California minus Oregon, if the entire interval were positive, we have evidence that a higher proportion of Californians were sleep-deprived. And if that entire interval were negative, we'd have evidence that a higher proportion of Oregonians were sleep-deprived. But here we see that zero is included in the interval, as well as some negative and positive values. And so what we can say is that because the interval contains zero, there's not evidence that either Californians or Oregonians are significantly more sleep deprived. That's it for this video. You can find more free resources on openintro.org.